And knowing is half the battle.
G.I. Joe!
Because knowledge is power!
We had an opportunity for a one-on-one interview with Sister Souljah before the highly publicized quote to discuss her views on a number of issues. What did you think of the Rodney King verdict?
I thought a lot of things about the verdict. I mean, I had a bet going with one of my friends that they were going to let them free because I believe that the American justice system is racist in its nature. And I don't believe that the reason why Black people can't get justice is because we don't have the criminals on videotape. I believe it's because of white racism. And so I expected them to let them free.
You're the only person I've ever talked to or heard respond to the verdict that said they knew it was going to come down that way.
Oh, yeah, I had a wage. I won some money on that one.
Is how much?
Small.
A lot.
A small amount.
What was your response to the violence that ensued after that?
Well, I thought that it was too bad that white America drove black youth to do that. You know, I felt like black people are civilized and rational. Black people had been seeing that videotape for weeks and months and had not reacted violently to the tape. After black people felt that the criminal justice system had exhausted its usefulness, that's when you saw the violence. And so I didn't have a negative response to it. And I'm not one of these people that, you know, is going to come out and say, you know, you young kids, you shouldn't have done that, because I believe that America brought that response on itself.
What do you say to people who say you're encouraging violence when you don't condemn it?
I think the verdict encouraged violence, not Sister Souljah.
What about Mr. Bush's reaction? How do you feel about him and what he had to say?
President Bush is former head of the CIA. I have no expectations of him where African people are concerned. I think that he's very clear about everything that's going on in the urban community as somebody who was part of the Central Intelligence Agency.
Some young African Americans have said that the old guard of the civil rights movement is out of touch. Do you agree with that?
Oh, yeah, they're definitely out of touch. Out of touch, or either they have too many entangled alliances in the sense that they cannot speak clearly and forcefully to issues because of who they might upset or how white America might accept it. They're like crossover artists, like pop artists, kind of like they have to water down their message or water down their rhythm or water down the truth. And I just don't believe in that.
If you were going to speak to Mr. Bush privately, the way they did, what would you say to him?
I would never speak to Mr. Bush privately.
Did you ever say, I read somewhere where you said you have never met any good white people?
I said in the beginning of my slavery video that I hadn't met any good white people. And my definition of good is that you understand that this is a question of power, that you be willing to give up some power, that you be willing to give up some resources, that you be willing to pay black people reparations for our years and years of service in this country, that you be willing to go home and tell your white mother and father about white racism and how it affects and kills black people in our communities. That's my definition of good white people, and I haven't met any like that.
Speaking of power, how about empowerment? One of the criticisms that the mainstream community has of us is that we are lacking in family values.
Right.
We're children having children and men running the streets.
Right.
What do you say to that?
Well, I think that the economic system in this country and the justice system in this country contributes to the delinquency and the destruction of the African family. I think the fact that 25% of the black male population is either in prison or under court supervision shows you that a lot of children will not have fathers. I think the fact that the economic system does not embrace or allow African men to have a substantial position in it is the reason why you have so many people committing crimes. So I think it's just hypocritical and some type of trickery for white people and the government and the media to say that there's something wrong with the black community and not draw the link directly to the white power system and how it's designed.
You have a survival guide for the black woman, for the African woman. Do you have one for the African man? Because you know he's endangered in this society.
No, actually the survival guide that I have on my album is for men and women. I don't separate the issues. I don't consider myself to be a feminist. And so everything that I say is for the survival of the black man and woman as well.
You know, you have sort of a mainstream, or some might say bourgeois education. You went to Cornell, you went to Rutgers. A lot of people might find that surprising. Where did you come from? Where were you born? New York City?
I was born in the Bronx. I was raised on welfare. I lived in Section 8 housing in the projects. I had a single female headed household. So the only difference between me and some other people is that everything that I talk about, I've experienced. I've experienced all the programs of the Great Society, whether it was Head Start, free lunch, free cheese, free peanut butter, clothes, rent subsidies, or whatever it was. Now, I distinguish myself from other people that may have gone to these institutions because I haven't forgotten where I come from. I'm not ashamed to say that I was on welfare. I'm not ashamed to talk about the pain that it causes in our community, and I'm not ashamed of myself in any way, shape, form, or fashion. I have absolutely no desire to be white.
What is the solution for us? Obviously, look at history. They out there, it hasn't been their help that's brought us here.
Right.
How do we go further? How do we move on?
I think that we as a people are going to have to examine our economic relationship to America and corporations and divest our money in the same way blacks in South Africa had to divest from corporations that controlled their economy. I think that young people buy a lot of sneakers and jackets and jewelry, shoes and stuff, and myself included. I think that we need to examine which corporations we're giving the most money to, and then we need to stop. And we need to not support anything that supports racism.